Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be on my January 2019 favorites. I can't believe that 1 month has already passed by of the new year, and it's just surprising how time passes by so fast. And I'm going to start this new series on my channel on monthly favorites, which I am hoping I'll be able to do all the months coming forward. And if you want to know what my favorites were in the month of January, then please keep on watching. First and foremost, my first monthly favorite has got to be my trip to Himachal. I took this vacation almost after more than one and a half years, and it was a great experience. If you haven't seen my Kasol videos already, you should definitely check them out. If you're not following me on Instagram, please do that. All the links are in the description box below. So that is my top favorite. The next product I wanted to talk to you guys about is something different, in the sense that every day it's my routine that I have a cup of matcha tea, and I'm sipping one right now as well. And my favorite brand that makes matcha tea has got to be Tea Trunk, if you guys know about them. They have these amazing flavors in matcha tea, and I feel like I've tried all of them except for one that is very new, I think, which is the raspberry flavored matcha tea. And I'm going to place an order once all my stock is over, so I'm just waiting for that. And matcha tea contains a lot of antioxidants, which is very helpful for your skin and health. And if you guys are wondering if you want to try that, I would definitely recommend that you try matcha tea. I'm not saying that you should go and purchase Tea Trunk. There are various brands out there, but I do like the Tea Trunk matcha teas. Now, the favorite products I want to talk to you guys about, the first one being is this Neutrogena Ultra Sheer Dry Touch Sunblock. So one of my beauty resolutions for 2019 was that I will start applying sunscreen every day, and trust me, I have been doing that since day one of 2019, and I feel that it has made quite a bit of a difference. Now, I love this product because it is super great in terms of what it cleans and what it does. And second of all, it doesn't leave my skin oily. It does dry out and will last all days. And that is the Neutrogena sunscreen. My favorite moisturizer that I've been using a lot in the month of January has got to be the Laneige moisturizer. I have also done a video on these Laneige water sleeping masks. Now, this is a great product. I don't know what more I can say about it. First of all, it moisturizes your skin to a great extent. It smells absolutely divine. So if you guys are still curious to try the water sleeping mask, I would definitely recommend it. And one of the products I recently purchased was the Dermalogica microfoliant, and this is how it looks. I will be doing an in-depth review on this particular product because I feel like this is one of the most raved about products, and it actually does the job, and I absolutely love it. It exfoliates my skin to the T. My skin has been feeling quite good, and it does brighten up your skin, and that is one of the skincare favorites I have. A few other makeup products that I continuously use in the month of January has got to be this Maybelline Instant Age Refine in the shade medium. This is the concealer I'm wearing right now. It is a full coverage concealer, so you don't have to worry about it, and it doesn't feel cakey, nor does it crease, so it's a great concealer. Other two products from Maybelline that I've been loving in this month has got to be their Master Chrome highlighters, both in the shade of Molten Gold and then Molten Rose Gold. Now, trust me, these are the best highlighters you can get at the drugstore. Just look at how pigmented they are, and these work, I feel, across all skin tones, and definitely they will work on the Indian skin tone as well. So if you want, you guys can check that out. The blush that I've been using for the longest time, and which still continues to be one of my most loved products, has got to be Milani's Big Blush in the shade Luminoso. Now, this is the blush that I'm wearing on my skin right now, and you can see that it is so radiant and it's peachy. I always overdo my blushes because I absolutely love them and I am not going to be apologetic about it. And it is the best blush out there, in my opinion. Then coming to my eyebrows, my favorite has got to be this Benefit Goof Proof Brow Pencil. I have also done a tutorial using this brow pencil and it, trust me, this is like the lazy girl's perfect eyebrow pencil because it gives you these very fluffy Instagram looking eyes, which I'm sure all of you guys want to know how to do it. So definitely check my video out and it is a great product. The next couple of things I want to talk to you guys about are my favorite mascaras. Now for the longest time, I've been using the Dior mascara and I still can't get enough of it. Now this is how it looks. It's called the Dior Show Pump and Volume Mascara. Now this mascara gives you amazing volume and lengthening effect. It's not a waterproof mascara and I'm fine with it because I feel like removing a waterproof mascara is like a huge pain, like it never comes out and the residue still remains. And I am not the biggest, like obviously you do need a waterproof mascara, but I'm not the biggest fan of it. And if you guys want to try a high-end mascara, I would definitely recommend the Dior one. Now when it comes to colored mascaras, like I've absolutely been loving the colored mascara trends and I have done a couple of looks with it as well. And the colored mascaras that I've been loving are the Kiko ones. The shades that I have are 1, 2, and 3. I can't recollect the names of these, but I will put them all in the description box below. So if you guys are wanting to try the colored mascara trend, you should definitely check my previous videos if you haven't seen them already. For Kajal, my favorite that I've been loving in this month has got to be this L'Oreal Silkisme in the shade Charcoal. Now this is not the blackest black that you get, but it's a little bit gray and has like chunks of tiny glitter. I'm not sure if you guys would be able to see it. I will try to zoom this in. It's a great eyeliner from the drugstore. It doesn't smudge on my eyes and it lasts all day. And the last makeup product that I've been absolutely loving in this month is this MAC Whirl lipstick. It's the Dusty Rose shade and it is a matte formula and this is how it looks. It's a perfect lipstick for everyday wear and it is one of my holy grail nude lipsticks. So in terms of makeup, those were all the products that I was continuously using in the month of January. And lastly, coming to hair. Now for the hair, I've been absolutely loving this Batiste dry shampoo in the shade Cherry. This is how it looks. Now this is a travel size. I did take this with me to Kasol as well because obviously it was freezing and I couldn't wash my hair. So this did a great job. It does give a little bit of volume. So if you do feel like your hair is feeling very greasy, then a dry shampoo is your best friend. If you haven't used a dry shampoo yet, Batiste has an amazing range and you should definitely check them out. And lastly, before going, one of my favorite things I've been loving in this month of January has got to be a podcast that I listen to. It's called Fat Mascara. You can listen to this on Google or Apple Podcast. I will leave all the links in the description box below. It's an award-winning podcast on all things beauty. So if you guys are a beauty junkie like me and want to know more about your makeup, skincare, or any other questions that you have, you should definitely listen to it. And it is absolutely free. So yeah, those were all the things I was loving in the month of January. I still can't get over the fact that January has already gone by and we are already in Feb. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.